Hello. In this video, we will know about what is investments. Right from our childhood days, knowingly or unknowingly, we have been learning investments in several ways. Well, in this video, we will understand investment as a financial term. In simple terms, investment means growth in money over a period of time. This money that we are talking about is in the form of our current assets, and it should also grow to give us future assets, which means it should be a value add to give us future economic benefits. However, often people get confused between what is assets and investments. So before understanding investments further, let us first clear the confusion on the difference between assets and investments. An asset is something that you own and has value. Assets can be appreciating and depreciating. Depreciation is when the value of an asset decreases, and appreciation is when the value of an asset increases. Some assets can also generate income over a period of time. Suppose you own a car. Now the car is your asset if you use it just for your personal purposes. However, there is no growth in money with that car. And as mentioned before, investments are supposed to give you additional monetary benefits. Now suppose you buy a house and give it on rent. Now that particular house is your investment, as it will earn you rental income, which means that the money that you invested in buying the property will grow in terms of rental income. So in this case, your money grows, which means that the house is an investment for you. Now coming to the types of investments. Investments are of several types. Investments in shares, equity, stocks, mutual funds, bonds, real estate being the common ones. Also, how can we forget e-gold? Do you think we all hold gold for investment purposes? Well, this is not entirely correct. We also hold gold for the safety in it. Gold is basically the safest mode of investment. Now coming back to the definition of investment as a financial term. As we discussed earlier, investment is growth in money over a period of time. So the period that we are talking here is the long-term time period. Let us understand this with the help of an example. Rohit and Rakesh started their investment in SIPs together with rupees 1000 every month, expecting annual rate of return to be 12% per annum. While Rohit decided to keep the money invested for 10 years, Rakesh decided to keep it for 5 years. At the end of their respective investment periods, due to the power of compounding in long-term investment, Rohit earned a return of rupees 2.30 lakhs approximately, whereas Rakesh with the investment of 60,000 rupees could earn only rupees 82,500 approx. So what do we understand here? Well, investing is a long-term scenario. The longer time you keep your money invested, the higher returns you will derive from that particular investment. In a nutshell, investment is a monetary asset which is purchased with the idea that it will give you return in future. It helps an individual to beat inflation handsomely, creating wealth, helps with saving taxes, and creates a handsome corpus to deal with different financial goals with ease, thereby gaining capital growth and income. Investment puts one's financial life in an autopilot mode and helps an individual plan his financials, which is one of the greatest challenges of life. Thank you for watching the video.
Investment in the securities market are subject to market risks. Read all the related documents carefully before investing. Such representations are not indicative of future results.